Ali Ergin Demirhan, I'm the editor of Sendika.org, a leftist web page on the labor movement, the social movements against neoliberalism. We are in broadcast for the last 13 years, and we have issued many struggles within Turkey or abroad. Taksim Square, the Gezi Park, was just a symbol, but there are hundreds of demands in this symbol, and you can find many people, hundreds of different demands, they united against this government, and they are cheering. We are against fascism. We want resignation of Tayyip Erdoğan, resign Tayyip Erdoğan, resign government. Now it's a political struggle, but it has many social roots, and we can say yes. Sometimes we can say it suddenly emerged, but not suddenly. Years of struggles accumulated something for this huge struggle. You see this book. This is a book telling the struggle of the tobacco workers, tekel workers, in 2011. More than 10,000 workers went to Ankara in winter, and they in slums. They lived there for 3 months in winter, and they said that we don't want to lose our jobs. We want secure job. The precarity will kill us. Precarity will destroy our life. It was a huge struggle in the Turkish working class history. We couldn't win that struggle, but I can't say that we lost everything. We learned a lot of things, and this struggle united many people from Kurdish and Turkish, Alevi and Sunni. Now, just 600,000 or 700,000 of workers are organized in unions, but there are 20 million of workers, 20 million of workers in Turkey. So we can't say that the working class unions, the trade unions, are strong. But we can say that they are so weak because they don't organize only the working class struggle. They are in the anti-war movement. They are in this Gezi Park direnişi or Gezi struggle or Occupy Gezi, whatever you say. The trade unions are effective in this all these struggles. 3 days ago there was strikes of public employees and the Revolutionary Workers Confederation, and there were workers from metal, health workers, energy workers, and workers from municipalities, the social service workers. And the public employees also, and some of them are traditional types of unions, some of them are new types of unions. And what I mean in new type of unions, they are organizing the precarious workers with short-term contracts, outsourced work, and some of them work. For example, 6 months they work and 6 months they are unemployed, etc., etc. Legally, the government or the laws don't let you to gain your rights. But these new type of unions, one of them is the Revolutionary Health Workers Union, and the other is the Energy Workers Union. They say that laws aren't enough, so. They don't let us to go on strike, so So we have to went on a militant struggle, for example, occupying the workplace, for example, blocking the main ways, the railways, or and the blocking the entrance of the workplaces, etc., etc. So they are struggling with new forms of struggle. Another strike is still continuing in Turkish Airlines. Yesterday and the day before, they were on Taksim demanding their jobs. There are still 205 airlines workers fired because they went on strike.
Turkish Airlines.
Yeah, in Turkish Airlines, and this struggle is nearly 1 year. It has been continuing near 1 year, and they are also in this struggle. At first days, in TVs, in newspapers, and there were news. They said that the strike has zero effect. Turkish Airlines is working very well, but day by day we have seen that the strike is effective. But government wants to show that you can't gain any rights going on strike. So the government is supporting the Turkish Airlines with a huge support, and illegally they are forcing the workers to work, for example, 15 hours a day, or they are working extra workers from there, outsourcing some of the work. But now the strike is affecting the flights. We know, and it's something uniting with this struggle in Gezi. I think we had hoped a general strike, but the unions couldn't go on a general strike. Most of the working class aren't organized in these unions, so you can say I'm calling to a general strike, but it can't be a general strike.
So when was the last general strike?
I can't remember.
Okay.
Why? Because there isn't a real general strike that we have seen for the last decades. It is illegal. The solidarity strike, general strike, and now this struggle is a chance, is a fortune for working class struggle, because many workers, for example, in press workers, journalists, went on demonstrations, went on actions for their rights in this process. So you can organize them, you can say that this is an opportunity, this is the your organization is that, and come and we can work together. It's a chance for trade unions. They can use it, or they can say that I don't see an opportunity in Gezi, in Square, in Turkish Airlines strike. I think people, the ordinary people, saw that, understood that we can gain something by struggling. We can be a political subject of the life. It isn't true that we can't do anything. This is the biggest thing, I think, in the case.